You know, Bitcoin is a candidate for that. It does, I think, some things well, and it's obviously it's evolving, and there are additional things like Lightning being done on top of Bitcoin.
Bitcoin miners create a block. It is added to the blockchain, right? With every block that is added to the blockchain, you are creating a more and more unbreakable chain of events and more faith and credit in the Bitcoin itself, which is why it's good, right? You can't even understand how these transactions are verified.
And I still don't get it, and neither do you.
So the problem with Bitcoin is it is so slow. It's like the mainframe programming of the past. And it's the only reason it's still around is because there was so much invested in keeping it around that, you know, we just kind of have to leave it there. And one day COBOL will die.
And for Bitcoin in particular, if law enforcement agencies or intelligence agencies can effectively crack the code.
What people need to recognize is that Bitcoin is the greatest thing to happen to the FBI.
We think that the Bitcoin network is the world's best monetary network, and it's not even close. The Bitcoin network is one of the more powerful innovations for money as a technology in human history.
Nothing about it from a collection of USPs that's particularly desirable. You have extremely long settlement time. You have extremely low programmability. It is not aware of any other system. There's no native way of issuing an asset in that system. You can't even do a pull transaction. You can't do anything that's interesting or unique there.
The Bitcoin monetary network under the hood to do everything cheaper, better, faster.
A lot of the discussion about Bitcoin views Bitcoin as a consumer of energy. A lot of the criticism directed at it is the consumption of energy. You know, the perspective I'm suggesting is very much the reverse, which is as a way to strengthen our energy infrastructure.
Are you serious?
So back to the internet. I believe the internet will have a native currency.
Really?
It'll have a native currency. And I don't know if it's Bitcoin. I think it will, because just given all the tests it's been through and the principles behind it, how it was created, and you know, it was something that was born on the internet, that was developed on the internet, that it was tested on the internet. It is of the internet.
More governments are kicking people off the internet than ever before. Last year, governments shut down the internet more frequently than in previous years.
Especially when you consider the entire world and countries like Nigeria or Ghana or India.
In India, it happened in parts of the country more than 100 times. 20 million walking out the court building, woo woo. Government announced that it was adding almost $21 million worth of Bitcoin to its balance sheet, and that's where you saw this huge bump up in the price. And yes, it has come off of those highs.
Technical standpoint, how those downloads are going right now. And I ask that given the fact that, what, only about a third of Salvadorans actually use the internet?
Right, and you know...
There are two huge and powerful street gangs in El Salvador. Marisol Vitrucha, or MS-13, and Barrio Diaz y Ocho, or 18th Street. They've been fighting a brutal battle for territory for decades.
Last week, there was a bomb placed outside the Justice Ministry, and about half an hour ago behind me, a car bomb exploded outside the Tax Ministry. This is sort of the latest tactic they've been using. There have been grenades thrown inside police stations. Police have been targeted all year, but the whole car bomb thing is really new and really scary.
Tiziano Obreda is an analyst with Crisis Group.
Some crisis group had already questioned the government's rhetoric or narrative that its security plan was behind, or was the main reason behind, this drop in homicides, and actually suggested that the gangs had decided to scale back their use of violence even before the pandemic.
President Bukele's Bitcoin announcement was made in a Zoom call to the CEO of Strike, a 20-something Bitcoin entrepreneur in the U.S. Strike and the Bitcoin Beach wallet are essentially used interchangeably in El Zante. But Strike is available nationally, and the company seems to be trying to tap into El Salvador's $4.5 billion a year remittance market. The app gives users options to send either Bitcoin or dollars to each other. When I signed up, the app prompted me to deposit money with a debit card or bank account. Sending Bitcoin was less user-friendly than dollars. So when folks in El Zante pull out their phones to make digital payments, they aren't necessarily using Bitcoin.
That's the whole thesis behind Strike. I'm a Trojan horse. I give no fucks.
I'm here to help Bitcoin to push this through.
And this is probably a fun time to mention that disaster relief is currently a booming industry that's getting the attention of private equity firms and Wall Street monsters. If you're looking for a career that isn't going away anytime soon, perhaps go into disaster relief instead of a dying industry like building roads, anything with water, or internet comedy writing.
That Bitcoin cannot be controlled from the outside because governments can make currencies worth zero, but governments don't have the power to make Bitcoin worth zero.
Court documents show that investigators were able to access the private key or password for one of the hackers' Bitcoin wallets. Now, the money was then recovered by a new DC task force recently launched by the Justice Department.
These solutions may end up encouraging more aggressive moves from the government.
Keep the philosophy, the accounting, the way of thinking about transactions, but then suddenly you can now do DeFi and other things. But what they've done is said, we will not evolve the base layer at all, and we're just going to build all this layer 2 stuff, which is usually highly fragile and centralized, and requires enormous effort at the base level to do anything.
You want to upgrade your shit, you need 400.
But that's the key. It's about fucking doing whatever. That's all it is. We want the
vote. There is no point.
What if that whatever is upgrading myself? You can't score.
Don't worry about it.
It's automatic 10 by default.
Loving something unconditionally doesn't mean you love it more. It just means you love it sadder.